Hello and welcome to TAIK. I'm Mohammed Adnan, and in this video, this is a part 2 of HR dashboard. So let's get started with that. Before that, just we'll have a recap on that. So in our previous video, we discussed about this, how the dashboard will look like, and then we understand the domain of the HR in the Excel file and what are things we can do it from there. And then we have input the data into Power BI. So now let's start with the next steps. The next step, I have added a calendar table here. So it says a calendar minimum and max date of it. So minimum and max dates right there, right? So there's a measure table here. These are the measures table here. So in this previous file, I have created a separate table for measure table. But according to experts of Power BI, they don't recommend to use the measures on a separate table. It is better to create on the same table to which the data is resides over there. Because the thing is, the A visuals are there in Power BI, right? Like decomposition tree and Q&A and key influencer. Those visuals may not work if you are going to use measures from a separate table. It has to be on the same table where the data resides. So for this demo, I'm going to create the measures on the same table itself. So let's create a minimum and max date. Two measures is that taken for date of joining and then resignation date. So clicking on the data and then new measure, so in date should be minimum of date of joining. And let's create one more for maximum date. Click here and new measure, max date equal to max of resign date. So click OK. Now from the top ribbon, let's create a new table. Let's calculate a table from DAX. So go to modeling and then new table. We can give it a name, calendar data equal to calendar, which is the DAX here. And the start date should be the minimum, the measure which you have created now, and the end date is the maximum measure which you have created. So click close bracket and then comment. So now look at the data. So this is the table for the calendar data, and this is the one for HR data. Relationship is an important factor, so we need to now set the relationship between these two tables. Now save this file. First of all, this should be on YouTube demo. Okay, so now let's have a look at the old file. Here, if you go to modeling and the relationship, so this is the relationship, right? So date of birth is joined with the date column, and date of joining is also there, and resign date is also joined to that. But as you can see, the active is only one, because from one table to another table, you can just make only one relationship as an active, and you can create multiple inactive relationships. So that's how it is. So let's create the same way in the new one as well. Going here, manage relationship. So clicking on new, selecting the calendar data on top, date here, and from here date of birth. I don't want this to be an active. This should be many to one to many itself. It will have unique record, and this will have multiple records, and this should be single. So click OK and click new again. Calendar data and date of joining, I want to make this as an active, so click OK and then click new. Same again, calendar data, select this and just go to the resign date. It also went to many, single and inactive. Click OK. Three of them have added here and then close. If you want to know in detail about what the relationship is all about, then you can refer to my video about the managed relationship in Power BI. But for now, in this video, I'm going to give a brief about it. So clicking again on manage relationship. So So here is a HR data, right? So I'm clicking on edit now. So many to one is, even though we created one to many, it has converted to many to one. That's not a problem at all. So it has bring up the HR data on the top here and current data at the bottom here. So what it shows is it has multiple records and this has single records. And here you have another options here. One to one means it has to be single record and this has to be single record. And one to many is, which I created earlier, is the reverse way of many to one. And many to many is, should be, it has multiple records and this table also has multiple records. But this should not be recommended practice to use this relationship, because this may result of some different calculations, different result on that if you are using a many-to-many relationship. But for that, you need to create a bridge table in order to convert this to one-to-many relationship. So the cross-filter direction is here, single is there, right? And also there is both here. It means if you want to filter one-to-many, I mean, if you're going to select in a slicer or something else, the calendar data is going to filter on the date of birth. If you set to both, it means it will act in the reverse way. If you select something on the date of birth, it will also filter the calendar table as well. It is a good practice if you're going to use many to one, it has to be on a single side itself. Those data which has a single record, it has to be in the single itself. So when you're using one to one, it can be both. You can apply this logic here. But here, as our data is many to one, it has to be single itself. Make this relationship active. As I just said before, you can create multiple inactive relationships, but only one has to be active one. So if I'm clicking on again here, it shows a message here. There is another already active relationship between these two tables. So I cannot able to save this, so I need to inactive this one. And there's an option here, apply security filter on both the directions. So it will help on the row level security. If you're applying a particular row level security for the HR data for an employee to the viewer and they don't have access to calendar data, means it can apply within this as well. So we are not going to cover in depth in this now. You can refer to that video. The link is given on top of your screen, also on the description below. So clicking cancel now and close. So that's it from the modeling part. Now we'll go into some visualization part. So first of all, we will apply the theme. So go to view here, and then we can select the theme from here. So in the previous file, I used this one, front end, so I'm just clicking here. Which changes the theme. Now let's check for the background colors. Here's the one, clicking on the blank area. And if I select here and the page background, it is this color. If I don't know this color, I can just click on more colors. This is the latest update from February 2020. And I can copy this value here, whatever they are given here. And the transparency is zero. Going back here, clicking on the blank area, selecting this and page background, and then more colors, just paste here. That's it. It changes the value here. Good, right? Okay, now we'll check for the any other measures which they have created or not. So going here in the measure table, I have added few measures here. As you can see, let me zoom this. Employee count, employee retention rate, employee turnover rate, male female ratio, max date, min date, and selected year. So these three, we can do this on the next step. First of all, we'll create the employee count here. So selecting on this, employee count equal to count of HR data employee code. So zooming out right here, I'm adding the same here. Click here and new measure, like count equal to count of employee code. Close the bracket and commit. Now let's add the visuals one by one. The first thing here, employee count by marital status and gender. So here, you see on this one, I used the employee count and I used the stat column chart. So clicking on the blank area and then stack column chart. It loads here. And I will add an employee count here in the value section. And then I need to add the marital status and the axis as well as the gender, right? So gender. So if you can see the gender I used on the legend, so let's drag and drop on the legend here. Then what it is going to split the value into different colors. So now I can see this value as well. And I don't have the thing is we need to format it a little bit. So zooming it here in the field format pane of this one, can go to data labels and we can enable this option. Let's hide this filter pane so that we can increase this a bit. So data labels here, turn on the data labels so that it can be visible here. This is data label here and the header doesn't look nice, so we need to change the font of it. So going here, the title employee count is okay, so I just need to change the font color of font size is 14, so let it be 12. Let's have a look at this employee count with marital status and gender. Zoom out, this is fine. As you can see, the font family is Segovia I have used here, but here the title, the font which used here is Verdana. It's because of the theme. Now if you want to edit the theme, I will also show it here. Go to view again and clicking on here, and at the bottom you have option customize current theme. So if you select here, it will open up this window. Here you have the default colors from the color palette you can select, and if you click on advanced, these are the colors which you can choose from there. And the text here you can select whatever you want. In general, I want to use the Segovia, the just color, and the font size should be 10 and font color is this. When it's come to title, I want to change this one to go bold, and for the cards and KPI it has to be the same thing, but I don't want this much of font, so I want to change it to 20. For the tab headers, this to be Segovia bold. Okay, and it comes to the font visuals, borders and all these things, let it be there. And if you want to make the borders for each and every visuals, you can also do that here. So I'm just turning on the borders. I don't want the colors to be there, but still let it be there. But if you want to change the radius, so 25, I'm setting it here. Okay, because I just want the curve here like how it is here, right, in the previous file. And if you look at that, in the borders area, its color is black, radius is 10, I have set up here because of the curve here. You can see it here, there is curve, look like the curve here, right? That's the thing. Now that's why I want to change this here to 10 as well, because by default for all the visuals it will affect. I don't want to change one by one. So that's the advantage of the theme customization. So when it comes to header, this is a thing, and tooltip, if you want to change, you can change that as well. And the page here, the page background, I have already set up here for the background as well. No need to change that. And in the filter pane, if you want to apply the colors for that as well, you can also do that. Apply for filters and filter cards. That's it. So if you click on apply, then it will change everything to all the visuals. If you just click on the blank canvas, yeah, as you can see, I have the borders with the curved edges and also the font, everything is changed here. That's a cool thing, right? So now I can copy this. So these are employee count by marital status and gender. So I can realign this to center. Let's see if there is an option to center alignment or not. So again, going here and customize current theme and going to visuals, headers. I don't have anything here to set up. And if you click on text and title here, no, there's no option to change the alignment here, unfortunately. So now going back again to filter pane of these visuals and then going to title and let them alignment to the center. Okay, done. So this is cool. So So married and unmarried, these are the ranges here according to male and female. Now the next thing is employee count by gender alone. So I am just used a pie chart here. So either you can copy the same visuals here, or I just want to add a new one to make sure if the current theme applies to that or not. So clicking on the pie chart, which is an evergreen chart. So selecting here, as you can see, initially stage itself, it has the curve edges. If you're selecting here and use the employee count measures in the value section and gender on the legend. So it brings up everything here, what I wanted here. So the next thing is you can readjust this and I can realign the title. It looks 14 here. I need to reduce this to 12 and center alignment here. And regarding the legend, it's just because of its right alignment, I need to change this to be on top center or top left. So left, it should be on top right, so right to top. So now it's showing the gender here and this values here. So now if you want to show the legend, the title as well, right? So if this title for you, let me zoom a bit. The gender is showing it here, right? Anyhow, the heading here, employee count by gender. So why do you want to show the text here? It is also not clearly right. So you can also hide that. In the visualization pane of the filter on the legend section, you have this option like legend, right? So you can just turn off the title, then it will give just these two things. We'll do for this as well. So turn off the title. And we have mentioned that under headings as well. So it is better to turn off this. So zoom out. Likewise, we can add all the visuals one by one in our upcoming videos as well. So these are part two of the HR dashboard in Power BI. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. If you're not yet a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.